costs money. Talk about funding.
Well, the new Chickamauga Lock will cost another $400 million over the next 5 to 10 years. We've already spent $200 million. Half of that funding will come, a substantial part will come from commercial users, the rest will come from the taxpayers. But I think of it the way I think of the road programs that we had in the 1980s. Tennesseans were glad to support the program that would create the best four-lane highway system in the state because it helped us attract Volkswagen and suppliers that now provide one-third of our manufacturing jobs. This is an investment in new jobs paid for in large part by people, commercial users.
So all this money that could be freed up with this logging capacity, how are you going to be able to prioritize which projects that money goes to? How are we going to be able to ensure the world is going to be able to see this?
Well, the Army Corps of Engineers, working with the users of the inland waterways, has established a priority system, and the Chickamauga Lock is the fourth highest national priority. The problem is the Olmsted Lock, which is on the Ohio River, is soaking up 90% of the money every year. So all of the available money, almost all, goes to this single lock on the Ohio River, and none to the second lock and the third lock, which are effectively in Pittsburgh, or the fourth lock, which is the Chickamauga. So we take that lock on the Ohio River completely out and pay for it with appropriated funds. And then if we double the funding that's available for the grants, it ought to be pretty easy to fund Chickamauga Lock quickly over the next several years, hopefully at a level of $35 to $40 million a year until it's completed.
It doesn't change.
Chickamauga Lock would be, well, in effect it would be third because the big lock on the Ohio River that's soaking up all the money would be out of the picture. It'd be paid for by appropriated funds. But right now everybody needs to understand work has ground to a halt on the new Chickamauga Lock. There's no new money for aggressive maintenance to keep the old lock open, and there's no new money to build a new lock. And this lock is not going to last forever. And if it closes, it would be devastating. Jobs, not just in the Chattanooga area, all the way up to East Tennessee, Oak Ridge, all the TVA customers, Olin Chemicals, all those people who use this transportation. And everybody who drives on I-75, they need to get ready for about 150,000 more big trucks coming to them.
And all your talks with the stakeholders, do you have any idea what the timeline is?
Well, that's hard to say. It would depend upon the rate of appropriation of the dollars by the Congress. But if you have $400 million roughly left to spend on the dock, the rate of spending might be anywhere from $20 to $50 million a year, something in that neighborhood, depending upon the money that's available to Congress and the ability of the Corps to spend it properly. So I think you're looking in the best possible situation to 5, 6, 7 years to complete the lock. That would be extremely good news since it's ground to a dead halt now, and under the present system of funding, there's no real prospect for it being built for a long, long time. So in fact, under the present system, the current lock holds not be used for the new lock to be.
Senator, given the financial boom of the country to control federal spending, do you consider this project appropriation, funding the project a slam dunk, or do you think there's going to be a fight as everybody tries to fight for what's going to be down the road, a limited pot of money?
There's no spending of any federal dollar that's going to be a slam dunk, nor should it be. But right now, what's driving the country into bankruptcy is that health care spending and mandatory spending is going up to rate 3 to 4 times inflation, while spending on essential services like locks, dams, ports, highways, national defense, national parks, already is a level funded. So if we can just get the mandatory spending for healthcare services to be funded at a prudent level, like we already have with locks, dams, ports, we'll be in good shape. I think the American people know, I think Tennesseans know that, why how we bring our mandatory spending under control. We better make sure we create enough good new jobs to create the revenues to pay the bills.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the increases in user fees for margins?
Well, the, generally speaking, the increases in user fees would be about 50%. And we've worked with the commercial users of the lock, and they agree with it as long as we have a new lock, because they'll be able to bring 9 times as much cargo through the lock. They'll be able to bring 15 barges through the lock at one time instead of one lock, and it will decrease their cost. And let me emphasize again, none of this adds a fee to any recreational user of the lock. So if you've got a boat and you live in Chattanooga and you want to go to North City, you don't pay a fee now to go through the lock, and you won't pay a fee under this plan.
A couple more questions. I just want to follow up on that. I remember, you know, Catherine, I've been here, there was talk about increasing the tax on barges. Is this increase in user fees kind of equivalent to that, just not a tax increase?
Well, user fees, like gasoline taxes, are paid for by people who use roads, people who use locks. The user fee we're talking about is a fuel tax for commercial users of the lock. It would increase, and we're going to go directly to help build.
So it is a raise
in the tax? Yes, it is. But that means that people who use the lock will pay more for new lock, and they're happy to pay. They support them. I'm here because they're saying we want a new lock to lower our costs, and we're willing to pay more.
What's the timeline for this? Continuing resolution for spending until March. Is there anything that we might look at?
Well, my hope was the new president. Whether we've talked with Vice President Biden about this, I've talked with Governor Romney's team about this. I hope would be the new president would propose the American Waterways Act as creating the kind of country that we all want, to make it easier and cheaper to create private sector jobs. And if the president gets behind it, there'll be a bipartisan group of senators ready to pass it next year.
Senator, one question outside of this. Chattanooga Free Press, along the strong voice of conservatism here in Chattanooga and the region here, has endorsed Gary Johnson, the Libertarian candidate, not the Republican candidate, Ben Romney. Any thoughts? It's highly unusual. It's taken a lot of people by surprise, and there's a lot of feedback from people in the community.
I think we have a free press in the United States, and I think the free press ought to stay a free press. My own view is that we need executive leadership in the country, and it's either going to be President Obama or Governor Romney. I think President Obama has a lot of good characteristics, but one of them is non-executive leadership. And Governor Romney, I believe, can get the budget agreement we need to turn the economy around and create new jobs. So I believe most Tennesseans are going to be strongly for Governor Romney, and I think he has a good chance of winning in 2 weeks.
Thanks, everybody.